Hello, and welcome to WiThrottle. In this video, we will be exploring some of the features available to WiThrottle by using the roster of JMRI. One of the core features of JMRI is the ability to read, write, and store the CV values for mobile decoders. These values are kept in roster entry files that make up the roster for your railroad. In addition to CVs, these files can contain other information about the decoders and the locomotives. Each roster entry must have a unique roster ID to identify the locomotive. The DCC address can be the same for more than one roster entry. For example, this pair of locomotives are both programmed to DCC address 366. They each will have their own roster entry file, CSJ366 and 366B. I could just use the same file for both, but there are sounds that I want deactivated in the B unit, since it should always have another unit as a lead. I will begin by opening the roster and creating a new locale. I know that the model installed is a Digitrax SDXH166D, but I will read type from decoder here. Here I have found the correct decoder model, and as it's reading everything, it will come up with the address that's already programmed into this locale. The ID is the name that will be displayed in WiThrottle, so choose wisely. I am going to name this locale CSJ366. Let's put a space in there. And then I will click Save to create the file. Afterwards, I will open the programmer window. The other information on the roster entry tab is for your reference, and you can fill in as much or little as you like. Good practice when creating a new entry is to read all sheets before doing anything else. This is not needed for WiThrottle, and it can only be done on a programming track. When that is done, save to roster, close the programmer window, select the locomotive again, and then go to the Labels and Media. On the Function Labels tab, we have a list of the 29 functions and space to enter an optional label for each. This decoder has default labels already in JMRI, and you can enter or change as many as you like. I will leave the default labels. The Lock column determines the behavior of the function button. A check mark on sets the function to latching. The function turns on and stays on with a press of the button, and turns off at the next press. With the check mark off, the function is momentary and only stays on until the button is released. As an example, this decoder only activates the crossing horn when the function turns on. Notice F10 is set to be a momentary function. Notch up and notch down also work this same way. When done making any changes to this window, we will save to roster. I created a second roster entry for the B unit. It has the same model of decoder. The ID is set to CSJ366B, and the address is 366. I also did a read all sheets to get the initial values out of the decoder. In the programmer for the B unit, I'm going to go down to the Sound Levels tab, and I'm going to turn off the bell volume and the horn volume. I'm also going to make slight changes to the air dryer rate, the compressor start, and runtime. I just want these values to be a little bit different than the A unit so that they run at different times. The bell and the horn, I don't want those to sound at all in the B unit. After making those changes, I'm going to write the changes on this sheet. And then I will go all the way back to my raster entry page and save to raster. My raster now includes two locomotives, so let's take a look at WiThrottle. Either version, WiThrottle or WiThrottle Lite, will work exactly the same for the raster and the functions. The app starts and connects to JMRI. On the address screen, we see the locos listed in the raster area. Selecting CSJ-366, we will then switch to the throttle screen. We have control of both the A and B units because it is sending commands to address 366. The function buttons are displaying the labels for each button that have text. The unlabeled buttons will default to the function number. Now, we are able to see the lock function of each of the settings. I will now switch to the B unit raster entry. The control will still send commands to address 366 and both units. However, the function buttons will use the labels from CSJ-366B. For a comparison, I removed the labels from this loco file and changed all of the lock settings to on. Now we can see that F10 for the crossing horn will latch on and will only sound the crossing horn for every other press of F10. Let's head back over to JMRI and make a few changes. There is no need to have both the A and B units show in the raster of WiThrottle. I'm going to create a raster group in the settings menu, and I am going to name it CHB. That's for Clove Hitch Bay. I will then open Raster Group Table Association. I'll select the CHB group, and then I'll choose to include just the A unit. Now, in the WiThrottle window of JMRI, we can set the raster group. When we set it to CHB, only locomotives in the CHB raster group will be sent to the WiThrottle app. So since the A unit is now set in the CHB group and the B unit is not, the B unit will not appear for selection in the WiThrottle app. Going back to the raster for CSJ-366, the Raster Media tab has one item that is used by WiThrottle, the icon image. It is not necessary to have an image, but if you want to include one, it will display in the raster area of the WiThrottle address screen. I happen to have an image for 366, and will drop it onto the space provided. The image does not have to be very large or have a specific aspect ratio. An image approximately 350 pixels wide and 200 pixels tall is about all that the current iOS devices will display in the available area. A larger image can be used, but it will take longer to send the file to the app. Don't worry about getting the exact size. The app will adjust it to fit. Technically, the ideal image has an aspect ratio of 16 by 9. If you add an image, don't forget to save. These images are sent to the WiThrottle app through the JMRI web server. We will need to start that feature to have the icon images sent. If you plan to use this feature regularly, Start Web Server can be found as a startup action in JMRI Preferences. Now let's go back to the WiThrottle app. The roster list on the address screen will now only have one entry, and it's for the A unit. It also displays the image that is associated with that loco. I will select that loco by its roster listing and set it. Before going to the throttle screen, I am going to change a setting. I will turn on Hide Unlabeled Functions. Now, buttons will only appear for functions that have a label. If a loco address is chosen that does not have any labels or has no roster entry, it will display all of the function buttons with the default numbers. One other thing that I am often asked is how to remove something from the recents list. That can be done by taking your finger and swiping it from right to left across the one you want to remove, and then tapping delete. Well, that about wraps up the roster features. If you come up with other creative ways to use it, please drop me an email. Thanks for watching and have fun!